Good morning, children. Welcome to science class. I think you have completed the chapter getting to know about plants. In today's class, I will revise some of the important topics in that chapter. First of all, I will discuss about the parts of plant. Now, this is a plant, one type of plant, and here there is a root system, and this is considered as a shoot system. And root is present below the ground. This is, these are considered as a root. And this is stem and leaves, and these are branches and small small bud and flowers you will come across in this plant. And flowers will give rise to fruit, and fruits will give rise to seeds. Okay, these are the parts of plants. A root, stem, branches, leaf, a flower, etc. are the parts of a plant. This is shoot system and this is root system. Root system is present below the ground and shoot system is present above the ground. Shoot system includes stem, leaf, branches, etc. And the root system only it includes roots. Okay, this is about the parts of plant. Next, we will discuss about the structure of leaf, or what are the parts of leaf. Here, we will consider one leaf. It is an example for one leaf. Okay, that is the structure of leaf. Mainly, it is having the stalk. Leaf is having the stalk. Stalk of leaf is called as petiole. I have written here, stalk of leaf is called as petiole. And the leaf where the petiole arises, that part is called as leaf base. And this broad structure, green color structure, that is called as leaf lamina. Full broad color structure, green color structure, that is called as leaf lamina. In that leaf lamina, inside that you will come across a middle one line, that dark line you will come across, that is called as a midrib. Midrib is the base of the leaf, and in between that you will come across thin lines like this. They are arranged in the form of network, that is called as veins. They are called as veins, and this is considered as a tip of the leaf. At the top you will come across a small portion that is considered as a tip of the leaf. Okay, these are the main parts of leaf. But this leaf is different in different types of plants. In dicot, it is different, and in monocot, it is different. In dicot plant, these veins are arranged. These veins are arranged in a form of network. Hence, they are considered as a reticulate venation. Reticulate type of leaf will come across in dicot plants. And you will come across in grass and all, paddy and all, you will come across a leaf like this leaf. You can see this type of leaf. Here I have done drawing that leaf. Here you can see veins are arranged parallelly. One vein is parallel to another vein. That is considered as monocot leaf, and then veins are arranged parallelly. There you can see parallel venation. In dicot leaf, you will come across veins are arranged in the form of network, that is considered as a reticulate venation. And here you will come across a parallel venation because veins are arranged parallelly. See, here this is monocot leaf. This is example for monocot leaf. Here you can see this plant's leaf. Okay, this is example for monocot, and this leaf is an example for a dicot leaf. This type of leaf you will come across, you can recognize this is dicot plant. This type of leaf you will come across, then you can recognize this is monocot. Here, there is a, by observing the leaf of the plant, you can say that whether it is monocot or whether it is dicot plant. And by seeing the root system also, you can say that whether it is a dicot plant or monocot. In dicot plant, you will come across tap root system. This is an example for dicot root system. Okay, tap root system. Main root will be there and small roots you will come across. And then in other plants, in monocot, you will come across fibrous root system. And main branch, you will come across that all the roots, that is fibrous root system. This is about the leaf. By observing the leaf as well as by observing the root, you can recognize which is dicot plant, which is monocot plant. Leaf is considered as a food factory of the plant because food preparation takes place in the leaf of the plant. This leaf will prepare their own food. In the plant, leaves will prepare their own food by using carbon dioxide, water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. And they prepare food, and what happened? Water as well as oxygen is released. That oxygen is used for respiration purpose. And that process of preparation of food in the leaf is considered as photosynthesis. In plants or in the leaf, you will come across a very important process, food preparing process, that is photosynthesis. Photosynthesis takes place in the leaf itself. And another one process you will come across in the leaf, that is transpiration. Transpiration means what? Water will come out from the leaf in the form of vapor, that is called as transpiration. Next we will go for very important, that is flower. It is a very attractive part of the plant as well as it is a reproductive part of the plant. You will come across different colored flowers, very attractive flowers, when you consider rose as well as hibiscus, and you will come across. And we consider hibiscus flower as a typical flower or model flower to study because you can observe all the parts in that. All the parts of the water flower in there. That's why we discussed about the structure of flower. We'll dissect the flower, we'll take out the flower, and we'll see the parts of the flower. I think you all done this diagram, leaf as well as the flower diagram. And I have sent one video to how to draw easily the diagram of flower as well as leaf. Okay, you can draw in any method, then, but you have to show all the parts. Now I will consider one flower. This is hibiscus flower example, and we consider this as a model flower for dissecting the flower. First of all, yeah, I told that this flower that is having stalk, that is called as a pedicel. A leaf stalk is considered as petiole, and stalk of the flower is considered as a pedicel. This is considered as a pedicel. Above that, you will come across a green leaf-like structure. This one. Okay, this is called as a green leaf-like structure. This is called as a sepal. This is called as sepals. And above that, you will come across an attractive, very attractive part of the flower that is called as petals. These are petals. They are very attractive part of the flower. And this is petal, and then you will come across a male part. Here you will come across male part. This is called as a stamen. This is a male part, stamen. And this is a female part. Inside that you will come across female part. I will take out it and I will show this female part. This is called as a pistil. Female part of the flower is called as pistil, and male part of the flower is called as a stamen. And petals, sepals and stalk. These are the main parts of the flower. Next, we have to consider male part of the flower separately. What is the male part called? Male part of the flower is called as stamen, and it is having filamen and anther, and inside that anther, you will come across pollen grains. Here, you can see this is a female part, and this here you can see one small line-like structure. This is called as a filament. Above that, you will come across a yellow color that is called as an anther, like head. You will come across anther, and in that you will come across a yellow powder-like structure that is called as a pollen grain. Pollen grains are carrying male gametes. They carry male gametes. And next, we will go for female part of the plant. Female part of the plant is called as pistil, or it is also called as carpel. You can open that here. You have to take out this sepals separately like this. Slowly you have to take out. All of you should try this Now you have to slowly, you have to take these sepals slowly. You have to take out that, and then you have to take out the water. Slowly you can take petals, you will take out petals like this, you have to take out, and then here you can see here, no sepals I will take out, here you can see, this is called as what, ovary, okay, ovary, and this tube like structure, this is called as stigma, sorry, style, and this is called as like this, this is called as what, stigma. Here you can see stigma, style, ovary, and this is bulged portion, swollen portion, this is called as what, ovary, and what it is, this is tube like structure, that is called style, and this is stigma, and this is male part. Okay, you can remove that male part also, you have to take out that male part, and if you open this ovary, inside this ovary here, and you have to cut and open like this, you can open, and you will come across inside that ovary, you have to open like this, you have to take out the hibiscus flower, you take that hibiscus flower, also try this, and see inside that, you will come across like this, okay, okay, slowly you have to take out, just you will come across here, this you can remove like this male part, and inside that you will come across, this one here you can see ovary, inside that ovary, you can take another, and inside that you will come across a pipe like structure, you have to joint it slowly, you have to take out that, like this, this is a style, like this, okay, you can remove the female, male part like this, then only you will get female part, male parts are removed like this, and only this one, male, female part, and like this, this will be attached to this, okay, usually, this ovary will be there, and then, like this, okay, style, stigma, and over inside that you have to take out this yellow color, no? You will come across small granules, inside this, okay, this is called as granule like structure, inside that you will take out, and this is called as ovules, and ovules, they are having a female gamete, they can say contain ova or eggs, they contain eggs, and in higher classes you will study about the form, in 7th you will study about the, and the reproduction in the plants, higher plants, how the reproduction takes. So this is about the important parts of flower, leaf, as well as parts, because it's a very important topic, we have to revise. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Thank you.